shout out to the chat. You guys are keeping it cracking. If you guys have any questions, please post them in the chat about anything, about the mysterious death of Eazy-E, about anything. And I know I've asked this question a few times, and I'm going to ask it a few more over the next couple of weeks. But post in the comment section what podcasts you guys listen to. Post in the comment section what YouTube channels you guys listen to. I want to do a little, you know, I'm doing a little marketing behind the scenes. So it all makes sense in a few weeks. But yeah, post anything in the comments. Let's see. Would Ruthless have been as big as it was without Jerry Heller?
No. No, no way. Hmm. No way. No way.
Tell me.
Nobody knew anybody but Jerry Heller. I mean, Jerry Heller was the key to the other side. I couldn't help him. I wouldn't help him with that. Okay? Nobody wanted to be the guinea pig on that situation. Jerry initially, if you remember Jerry, you got to understand Jerry. Jerry initially came in as, I work for Eric, I work for Ruthless. Okay? Mm-hmm. He kept enough distance between him and Eric as his manager. If this shit blow up, I won't get nothing on me. Okay? But if it work, I'm right there. Okay? Mm-hmm. It wasn't until the end he started talking about he was partners, okay? Mm. When and this is contrary to the movie, Jerry don't carry no boxes. Jerry was introduced to Eazy-E through Lonzo, okay? Jerry, when I introduced Jerry and Eazy together, Jerry pulls me to the side and says, Lonzo, how does the Jewish guy from the Valley deal with a group called Niggas with Attitude? I said, Jerry, very carefully. Wow. Okay? Very carefully. And he was not all enthused about that. I mean, everybody's a goddamn hero after you win the Super Bowl. I called the play. I saw the play coming down. I had a dream about the play the night before. Bullshit. 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 Okay? He was very concerned about everything. He didn't know how to deal with it. Eazy was the first one of us that came out when, you know, not being so much of a businessman. You know, I came from a business background. I'd had nightclubs since 79. Rudy from LA Dream Team, he ran Wendy. He was the Wendy's manager. These were people that Jerry dealt with. You know, we wore slacks and had briefcases. Eric kept all this money in his goddamn sock. Mm-hmm. Okay? Jerry didn't know nothing about that. You know, he had dealt with black guys before, but he had never dealt with no street black guys before. That wasn't his forte. He didn't want to deal with Eazy in the beginning. He, you know, man, I don't know this guy, dude. He carries his money in his sock. Whoop, 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 whoop. I mean, hey, man, you know, and Eazy stayed on him. And once they started having some mild success out of Makola, he was able to get him a deal over Priority. The rest of it is history. It's easy to say after the fact that, you know, this could have happened, that could have happened. But what nobody was checking for a black group out of Compton named N.W.A. And the people, if anybody who was around, the world wasn't checking for them. They was getting this shit. They was catching hell, man. They was catching hell from the vice president's wife, okay? Ain't nobody had no issues with the vice president like they did. I mean, Al Gore was the vice president at the time, and Tipper Gore they was on her radar big time. So, same thing with C. Dolores Tucker. She was on their ass.
Yeah.
So they didn't come out the box with no fanfare. They came out the box with a lot of controversy, a lot of shit. And later on, after shit eased up, everybody started to embrace them, and it changed up for them. Okay. Mm. And unless you understand all that and seen all that, you wouldn't understand the transition, then you understand the position that people like myself had. Okay? I could, if I had brought NWA, Niggas with Attitude, to my executive producer, Larkin Arnold, or Gerald Busby, people who I associated with back in the day, they'd have threw my ass out the goddamn window like homeboy from Fresh Prince. Get the fuck out of here. That wasn't a black thing, man. That wasn't a thing that a black man in the 80s could have done.
Damn.
It wasn't that dude. It wasn't that kind of party, man. That was not something as Lonzo, as a black man, anybody could have took to the forefront. to some black executive black producers or executive producers and not get your ass tossed out at the NAACP meeting.
Damn, that's so deep when you put it in that perspective.
Okay. They'd have had my ass on a rotisserie at the NAACP meeting, like a big ass goddamn pig and a luau. Man, I'm not going out.
That's right,
this.
Yeah.
You know, and right. I didn't have the wherewithal for that shit. And the shit was never supposed to go mainstream. It was all underground. Mm-hmm. It was meant to be underground. That was the whole purpose of the shit. It was meant to be underground. Mm. Mainstream was never the intention for NWA. And eventually, after some edits and some other stuff, and Greg Mack did some things with Boys in the Hood, that got some play, and then that whole situation started to muster under them. They came out with the album. They were doing so much content on the album. I was like, oh, hell no. We can't fuck with this right here. All the bitches and hoes. In fact, at that time, I was in partnership. I created this company called West Coast Record Distributors, me, mm-hmm. Egypt, Rudy, and an unknown DJ at former West Coast Record Distributors. And we had to meet with Jerry Heller to have him make a choice, man. Because we didn't see that, okay? We understood the impact they were going to have on our community, okay? The money hadn't got there yet. And this is the one thing about us as people, we have to start, I think we need to start looking at in a little bit different way. When you start talking about, oh man, why you hating on folks? You blocking them from making their money. Trust this. All money ain't good money. Okay? All money ain't good money. And that was something we had to conclude with, because NWA was trying to be a part of West Coast Record Distributors, and we weren't having it. And we told Jerry Heller, and if you want to manage them, that's cool, but you can't manage us. I still had a few months left in my contract. Egypt stepped off. Rudy stepped off, and I was kind of stuck, but he just transferred me over to Atrin. That's how me and Atrin got so tight. And I still was around, but I really wasn't with it. But again, eventually, Unknown started working with Ruthless on some things, and you know, him and Dre always stayed tight. You know, it just was a different evolution, man. Something you'll probably never see again in life.